In this video, I'd like to recommend some websites that you can use to support your learning process and to learn more about HTML and the web technologies. My favorite site for API reference is the Mozilla Developer Network. This is maintained by the Mozilla Foundation. And in here, you'll find information about basically all HTML tags, what their attributes are, which attributes you should no longer use because they're being deprecated and things like that. Normally, if you search on Google for any HTML tag and you add MDN or Mozilla, it'll take you to the corresponding page. And I've never really used this search engine they have. I just searched it through Google, but this is a great place to find standard compliant information. Another good website is caniuse.com. There are some features in HTML that are not fully supported by all browsers. There are newer features. An example of those newer features, which are by the way very exciting features, and I'm really hoping that they'll soon be supported by all browsers. One of them, for example, is the input date, which is an input field that you can have to ask a date for the user. So it will show a calendar, and it just works out of the box. It's pure HTML. So this website, you can search for any HTML tag, and it will show you which browsers support this technology and which ones are in the process of supporting it and which ones simply do not support it. So before using any cutting edge feature of the language, make sure to check on caniuse.com to see if it's supported or not. On Zenva, we have a few different blogs, and one of them is the HTML5 Hive, which contains a lot of free tutorials on web development, a lot of material on HTML5 and JavaScript. And in here, you can also find a free ebook, which covers similar content as this course, as this module, but with there are a few things that we've covered in the course that are not here, and the other way around as well. And there's also a free online course on HTML and CSS, which is a simplified version of what you've been learning here, but there might be some content that's not repeated on both. There's actually a fair amount of stuff that's in one course and not the other. Lastly, we've got our YouTube channel, which contains a lot of videos that you can obviously watch for free. So if you go to our YouTube channel, the Zenva YouTube channel, and then you go to playlists section, you'll see all the videos sorted by topic. So you'll find a bunch of videos on, playlists. You'll find videos on HTML, videos on JavaScript, videos on all sorts of web technologies and also other topics like web development and mobile app development. So there's another website that is very popular with people that are learning to code, which is the W3 Schools. So that one shows up on Google usually. The W3 Schools is a website to be taken with a little bit of care, because it does have very good explanations for beginnings, but they're not always standard compliant. That's why I actually prefer the Mozilla Developer Network, because they do a great effort into enforcing these standards and teaching you like the correct way to do things. But having said so, I have to recognize that I use this website sometimes, everybody does. So it contains a lot of good, quick explanations for things, but just don't forget that there might be things that are not fully updated or that are not fully standard compliant.